Hi, we will start in about 1 minute. Let me share my screen. Hi everyone, I am Alexey, developer of ClickHouse. Today I will tell you about new features and roadmap. Let's start with the new features for year 2021. So, the first is window functions, probably the most appreciated. People often come to me and ask a question. Does ClickHouse support window functions? And recently it was just a dream. But now this dream comes true. And the answer is yes. This dream comes true with full correspondence to the SQL standard. So we support basically everything. We support over partition by, order by statements. We support to calculate every aggregate function over windows. We have window close, frame specifications. We support specific window functions like rank, dense rank, row number. So I cannot say many about this new feature because it is implemented, it corresponds to the SQL standard, and it works. We still have experimental flag, but it is going to be removed because this feature is proven to be working perfectly. The next feature is quite broad. It is about native integration with Postgres. So you can query your Postgres tables from ClickHouse. You can both do select and insert. Of course, you can join Postgres tables with ClickHouse tables inside ClickHouse. You can even create a database inside ClickHouse that will automatically represent all the tables in external Postgres schema. You can use Postgres as a dictionary source. Recently, it was available only with ODBC interface. But ODBC interface is not very convenient, not very performant, and native implementation is way better. And as a bonus, ClickHouse itself can pretend to act like a Postgres. You just uncomment this line in configuration file, and ClickHouse will listen specific port, and you can connect with Postgres client to ClickHouse. And you can execute ClickHouse queries with this interface. Of course, you have to use ClickHouse dialect because ClickHouse will not automatically support all Postgres queries. But some queries will work without any changes. So what do we have? How it is implemented? We have PostgreSQL storage engine. So you can create table with engine equals to PostgreSQL. And when you query this table, either with select or insert, it will go to Postgres. It will translate the query, push down predicates that are compatible with Postgres, fetch data, and process it further to the final result. It is also available with PostgreSQL table function. You just write select from PostgreSQL, and you can use shards and replicas. So ClickHouse also automatically implements sharding for Postgres. It sounds quite insane. In this example, here are three replicas. You can also specify shards with comma instead of pipe. And ClickHouse will select every shard and one available replica on every shard with automatic failover. It is similar to MySQL integration that we already have, but for PostgreSQL. And what is upcoming is support for replication from Postgres. So data from Postgres, ClickHouse will subscribe to this data and automatically insert and even update this data in ClickHouse tables. This feature is already available and I welcome you to use it. What is also about PostgreSQL? As a bonus, we have implemented PostgreSQL style CAST operator in ClickHouse dialect. Let's look at the motivation. The problem is when you write just select CAST, something, for example, as decimal. This something is just a floating point number. If the precision is just 10, it looks to work all right. But if you increase precision to 30 numbers, it does not look all right. So you wanted just 1/10, but you get something very unusual. Instead, you have to put your number inside quotes. It will work all right even with maximum precision. But currently, in the most recent version 21.6, we also support writing it in PostgreSQL style with two colons. This acts as a CAST operator and it parses the literal according to the data type. So ClickHouse is very friendly system. ClickHouse is user friendly and ClickHouse is system friendly. So ClickHouse loves Postgres. ClickHouse loves MySQL equally well, I guarantee. And also ClickHouse is trying to love many more systems and integrations. S3, HDFS, ODBC, Mongo, Redis, Cassandra, Arrow, gRPC. Some of these systems deserve more love. And we will do it. What about interesting new integrations? Recently, we added support for gRPC protocol inside ClickHouse. Just enable gRPC port in configuration file. And it will enable a protocol that you can use from almost every programming language And this protocol has some benefits to the already available HTTP REST interface. The benefits are bidirectional interaction with query progress, query cancellation, sessions. Basically, it has feature parity with native protocol. And as an example, we have implemented ClickHouse client on Python with gRPC. So you can write your own ClickHouse client in every programming language you like Go, Rust, Scheme, Haskell, whatever. About something small but important. We have extended the range of supported values for date time 64 data type. Recently, it was just from the beginning of Unix epoch to the year 2106. But what if you want to write your grandfather's birthday into ClickHouse? Or what if you want to write the maturity date of your mortgage? Probably the range until 2106 will be not enough. So now you have 222 years more for free without any performance drawbacks. Up to 2283. So I hope our grandchildren will be able to use ClickHouse. ClickHouse can also parse HTML. And ClickHouse can do it in 20 gigabytes per second. No, it does not use regular expressions for that. It is using highly optimized code with simp instructions, all that we like. It is best effort function. It can process HTML and XHTML. I made some experiments. I created a database with about 10 million web pages, and I can so easily search through the text of these pages with powerful full scan query at 20 gigabytes per second. About interesting integrations. One of that is support for OpenTelemetry. It is needed if you use ClickHouse inside your infrastructure with multiple microservices. ClickHouse is not a microservice. It is mega service, but it is still can be used in your service mesh. And you can profile your service mesh with OpenTelemetry. You can import the data into Zipkin. The data is available in system OpenTelemetry log. We have support for generic compression formats for import and export. For example, you can create a table that will read from URL and automatically decompress data in XZ format, ZSTD, GZ, Brotli. BZIP2 is coming. What about new data types? We have one very interesting. It is map data type. So ClickHouse is mostly for well-structured data. And usually when you use ClickHouse, you have to split your data in multiple small columns. But sometimes you have some addition, like user attributes or miscellaneous data that looks like just a key value map. And now you can create a column with data type map and select data easily with natural syntax. By the way, if you want to create key value dictionary inside ClickHouse, you can use special table engine that we added recently. It is named embedded RocksDB, and it is implemented with RocksDB, obviously. What's new in SQL dialect? We have plenty of new features. For example, recently we only have union all. Now we have union distinct. We have support for common table expressions. By the way, it is implemented also by my friend Amos Bird. We have transparent type casts for subqueries in in section, in join, and many, many other enhancements. The next is semi-duplicate text search. It will be very difficult to explain, but I will try to do my best at hand waving. So, suppose you store different texts inside ClickHouse, like some books, some theses of students, and you want to search for some texts that are not complete duplicate, but are semi-duplicate. So some content is probably copy-pasted. It works with min hash algorithm. How min hash algorithm works? I have not much time, but I will try to explain. First, extract every consecutive single of several words from text. Several consecutive words. Second, calculate hashes of every shingle. Third, select several minimum values of hashes and maximum values of hashes. Fourth, calculate hashes of hashes. And five, texts are duplicates if at least one of these hashes are equals. Difficult to explain, but I don't have enough time, so let's continue. But this will be even more difficult to explain. We have variety of statistical tests inside ClickHouse. For example, student t-test and welch t-test for testing if two different samples have different means. I will not try to explain how different these statistical tests are, but if you are into statistics, you will definitely figure it out. And also we are going to implement Cramer's V and Thiel's U. I don't know what will come first. Projections. It was announced in previous talk, so I will not repeat. But if you missed the previous talk, I can say that projections allows you to store different data representations inside single table. For example, you can store pre-aggregated data, and it is updated atomically and consistently with the main data in table. When you do select, the best projection will be chosen automatically, and query will just run faster without any modification. The only question was remaining is, shall we merge it today? But it is not a question anymore. This feature is merged today. congratulations. It is already available in the latest build from continuous integration, and it will be released in stable version in June this year. Hedget requests. If I have a time to explain. So Hedget requests is when you do distributed query to multiple shards. And every shard has multiple replicas. Some replicas can be down, and ClickHouse will automatically fail over to another replicas. It is what is already working, what was always working. But what if some replicas are just slower than other replicas? In this case, we have implemented Hedget requests, and ClickHouse will calculate some timeout and try to speculatively connect to another replica that can be faster. So what about the features that are not already available but will be available this summer or this autumn or at least this year? Our roadmap is available publicly. You can read it on our GitHub. Let's review the most interesting or just what I want to highlight the most. We have plenty of upcoming features. Let's go to the most interesting. Support for semi-structured data. So what is about ClickHouse? ClickHouse is column-oriented database management system. It is fast, efficient, storage efficient, CPU efficient, because it works with well-structured data. But what if you have some part of data that is not so structured? For example, arbitrary JSON. We are developing a feature that will allow you to just store arbitrary JSON values inside ClickHouse. And you can query this JSON values with natural syntax. Natural syntax like path lookup with support to star, with support to schema on demand. So you can just specify the type that you want. But what is the magic about this feature? The magic is that data is automatically split into dynamic subcolumns, and these subcolumns are stored in column-oriented format. And as a bonus, what is already available is multiple levels of nesting for nested types. Isn't it wonderful? So what we have even more interesting? Just-in-time compilation in ClickHouse. So why ClickHouse is fast? Actually, why ClickHouse is not slow? There are only two ways how to process queries not slowly. First, vectorized query execution, and second, runtime code generation. The best result can be achieved with vectorized query execution if you do it just as single technique. But even better if you use both. And ClickHouse use both techniques to achieve the maximum performance. Just-in-time compilation was available for almost 3 years, but it was not enabled by default, because it was not 100% reliable. But recently, we just made it production ready. I want to show you very unnatural query, but it is just an example to highlight the difference in performance. So you want to calculate Murmur hash in SQL. I don't know why, but if you do it without JIT compilation, just in time, it was just 34 gigabytes per second. Quite fast. Quite fast, if you don't consider that it can go even faster. 87 gigabytes per second, 2.5 times faster. I have no idea why do you need to calculate Murmur hash in SQL with this ridiculous speed. But this is what ClickHouse will deliver for you. What is probably one of the most complicated, but also one of the most appreciated. It is to provide alternative to Zookeeper, to eventually get rid of Zookeeper and ditch it away. I heard people don't like Zookeeper. Actually, Zookeeper is not bad. It works. It works correctly. And this is the most important. But we want to change it. And to provide different coordination service that will also work correctly, but it will provide Zookeeper protocol, and it will allow us to fix multiple issues. And the main issue is to allow less operational complexity. You will just have to install less amount of components, less amount of services. You just install ClickHouse server and it will coordinate by itself. Another, I have just a few minutes, but I will try to explain a little short circuit evaluation. So you want to calculate the remainder of division. You cannot divide by zero. You write it in conditional expression. But ClickHouse also argues division by zero. If you write it in where with and, so probably division by zero shall not occur. But you get the similar exception because both branches are calculated. Even if you do it inside subquery, this subquery will be optimized away and you will get division by zero. We want to fix it by introducing short circuit evaluation. User-defined functions. Yes, we will implement user-defined functions. We consider five different ways to do it. And I can guarantee that two ways will be used. And other are just different implementations that we consider. We have replicated databases, so you will not have to create every replicated table by hand. You just create replicated database and every table will be replicated automatically. We have distributed processing of external datasets to separate storage and compute. This is already available. Processing of external data from S3 on cluster. And I have just 1 minute. What is probably the least useful, but people just want it? People don't like XML, so we will support YAML configuration for you. It will work in the same way, but just YAML instead of XML. So that's it. Please ask your questions. I will answer either in chat or live. Thank you for listening. I am ready. to answer your questions. Okay, so Oystons, sorry about your grandfather, but I hope at least your father will have the date of birth that can be stored in ClickHouse. If not, you will have to continue use integer or string instead of date time 64. Shailesh Gupta, is any there any plan to make ClickHouse cloud friendly, like scaling up or down easy? Yes, this is in our roadmap, and we consider two ways of implementation. One is in roadmap for 2021. It is about separation of storage and compute. For example, you will be able to store merge tree tables in external storage, and you will be able to dynamically allocate more servers on demand to process this data. If you need more compute, you just create more compute nodes and process this data. Sometimes it can be less efficient than if your data is on local file system. So we consider another way of implementation, dynamic resharding. It is not in roadmap for 2021, but it is only because I just not 100% confident about it will be available in 2021. Maybe it will be available at the end of this year, but maybe just in 2022. Geoffrey again. Will Zookeeper alternative allow copying of sequential nodes? At least it will be more easy because we control the implementation. From the start, the implementation will support the same Zookeeper protocol. You can even use these servers to power different systems that require Zookeeper. So you can use ClickHouse. It is named, by the way, ClickHouse Keeper. quite a cool name. You can install ClickHouse Keeper to control your Kafka, but I heard that Kafka no longer requires Zookeeper. Artur Takarchuk, are window functions scoped to a block? No, it is full-featured window functions. It works as expected. It works correctly. You don't have to worry about the block size anymore. You just write your query, and your query works as expected. Can window function processing be parallelized? The query will be parallelized before the step of processing window function. Then window functions will be processed sequentially. So data has to be sorted, and there will be sequential calculation on sorted data. Probably we will be able to optimize it further, but now it is sequential. But if you do heavy filtering before window functions, it does not matter. The most heavy work will happen during filtering stage. Sergio Hlihor, is there any plan to support some form of data locality where clients could be aware of nodes where data resides? Yes, and it is already supported. When you create distributed query, you specify sharding key. The sharding key can be random, then no locality at all. It can be specific to your usage scenario. For example, you can shard data by user identifier. This is typical. And you can enable a setting to skip unavailable shards. This setting is quite powerful. It will just skip querying, not skip unavailable shards, but skip unused shards. So irrelevant shards will be just skipped. But it is actually more powerful. If you write user identifier in the list of identifiers or in the list of identifiers, this list will be filtered to smaller list and smaller queries will be sent to every shard. And we also have an option to do local joins and local subqueries. So when you write something in subquery, you have two options: to execute subquery independently on every shard, assuming the data is sharded by the key on the key that you join this data. Aditya Shah, is automatic data backup on roadmap? Yes, it is already in development. Native support for backup and restore inside ClickHouse. You will be able to backup and restore all server, specific databases, subset of tables, or even subset of partitions inside tables. You will be able to create incremental backups, and you will have different options where backups should be written. The options include local file system and S3 storage. So you will be able to just write a command like backup into S3, the bucket. It will write data into this bucket, probably referring the previous backup for incremental backup, and you will be able to restore on different server. Yes, it is for year 2021. You can follow the pull requests on GitHub and track the progress. Any more questions? Feel free to ask in the chat. I will be happy to answer. And I will check the list of attendees. Is there any familiar people? Alexander Rubin, hi. Amos Bird, thank you for listening and thank you for projections feature that is merged today. Vadim Tkachenko, hello, by the way. I'm happy to see you in the list. The next question from Amos Bird. Could you tell a little bit more about dynamic resharding? It seems very appealing. The basic idea is to add additional level of sharding map that will be available to dynamically remapped between servers. So you will have not just single shard per server, but for example, 10 shards that can be moved between servers in background. It will give multiple advantages. For example, if one server was down and you create another server and it has to be restored, it will download data from multiple another services, and the load will be more uniform on your cluster. But this is just one of advantages, and there are multiple challenges in the implementation. And the main challenge is to support some data locality by primary key. So if you have some small query, for example, clickstream data for a single website, this query don't have to touch every server, and it should have not large fan out. And another challenge is insert fan out. So if you do multiple not so large inserts, these inserts should also not be split into even more amount of small inserts. This is a big challenge. So we consider some ways of implementation. And I am not 100% confident to include this feature into roadmap for 2021. But I am still optimistic. Okay, any more questions? Does projection enable resorting? Yes, this is the main use case. You just create projection with different order by key. And when your query can have benefits of different sorting key, it will use this projection. The main use case. You can even create projection with a subset of columns to save the space, but enable different sorting for this subset of columns. About online resharding. Would this also mean online resharding on live scaling clusters? Yes, this is the main motivation for this feature. If not, we will not even consider implementation. This is the main use case. So data will be able to move in background. Every shard will maintain the sharding map and different versions of sharding map. And queries will be able to use a previous sharding map while data is being moved. Okay, the last chance to ask your question. Right now, tiering in query processing and storage needs a lot of manual configuration. Will there be any support for automating this? I hope it will be. I will not give you any time estimate, any schedule today. But please follow our GitHub repository. Keep track on the proposals and the roadmap, and the news will come. Okay, so I was very happy to see you in the list of attendees. Thank you for attending to my talk. And I will go to the next room. Thank you.